So it's been a part of my life for a very long time. But just so you're aware, this is Bob's nieces who've joined me today to help do that, which is a great honour for me too, because it really should be his family doing this as well. And obviously it's Bob's birthday today, so it's really a great thing to open this today for people to see and then we'll pass. 1, 2, 3. Hooray!
Well, thank you everybody. I'm so grateful that all of you have been able to come along, and especially thank you to the Mayor and to Astrid and Sue Pelham for unveiling the plaque for us. Bob Pelham once said, "A puppet isn't just a toy, it has to walk, sing, act and dance for someone." When you see puppets hanging up in rows or on displays, you can almost hear them sigh as you walk past, because puppets, they want to be brought to life. That's what puppets are all about. They seem almost to yearn for life. They dream of action. Their entire wooden ambition is to become animated.
We are the city men, doggy, doggy, city men. We are the city men, so let the cymbals clash.
Other people now I'd like to introduce you to. First of all, Bob's nieces are here, Sue and Astrid, and as you saw, they joined the Mayor in unveiling the plaque, so I know they'd like just to share a few thoughts with you as well. Thank you.
He just would think of a creative solution to a problem, really. And he wasn't in himself confrontational, he wasn't somebody who liked to put anybody down or do anything unpleasant to anybody. But he was very intelligent, and he made some very clever moves, and I always felt that it was he was a very great man in humble clothes.
As president of the British Puppet and Model Theatre Guild, the oldest puppet organisation in the world, it's such a pleasure to hear and talk about Bob Pelham, also because he encouraged me to fulfil my wish to become a professional puppeteer. In June 1963, I wrote a letter to Bob Pelham, and he replied saying that John Wright had opened the Little Angel Theatre in Islington in London. He may be able to help you. I visited the puppet theatre and became John Wright's second apprentice. So it was an amazing thing, and I've still got the letter today. I can show it to you afterwards. I don't know, but some of you might recognise this little character here. This is Zippy from Rainbow, and I was 20 years working this little character. Now, this is the little version of Zippy. The big puppet was quite like a Muppet-style puppet, but oh, hello, everybody. It's very nice to be here. Sooty, would you like to give everybody a wave properly? Properly? There you are, lovely. Have you brought your magic wand? You have. But you're going to get it out of the bag. Pardon? I've got to. Right, okay. Say to everybody how wonderful it is to celebrate Bob Pelham's birthday. I know him. You know him? Oh, yes. He's a very clever man. Oh, well, I know that. You're not.
Well, Bob and my dad met after the war. They'd both been in services, and they always had that in common. So we were friends for life. And we originally demonstrated his puppets in Gamages, actually. And then we did our own show in Harrods a year later. And by that time, our puppetry completely went bananas. Bob's sales went up and up. And when I was 10, we wrote the plays for Bob Pelham's original plays. Because what David said is absolutely right. Bob wanted puppets to be able to say something. And of course, children are very creative. They make up their own thing. But he wanted a play for every puppet, which was nearly impossible. But my mother wrote the first book, and I wrote the second book with her in our garden in Highgate. And because I was only 10, and I'd written quite a bit of it, she insisted I had my name on the book.
Great. Where are we? What? Where are we? Sorry. Told you where we are. We're in Marlborough for Bob Pelham's blue plaque unveiling. Try saying that without moving your lips. Stop it. Now look, how have you been? Not good. Not good, no. Why not? Well, for most of the day, you've had me stuck in a flipping suitcase. No. I meant when you were out of the case. Still not good. Why not? I'm sick of this weather. Well, it's been quite sunny. I know that it's raining today. It's been chilly and I don't like it. Right, I've booked my summer holiday already.
You have?
Yeah, it's going to be fantastic.
Brilliant.
Where are you going?
Where are you going?
You got our lines mixed up then.
Yeah. Actually, you said my line.
I think they all know that that's your fault.
So I'm going to end with this, which is that one from the playbooks, which is Bimbo. And it's a little play from our book, and it says, "The time has come to say goodbye. This ends our little show, and I must try to do my best to thank you before you go. You've laughed in the right places. It's really been a treat just to see your faces. Made us laugh, to say the least. So there's one remaining thing for me to do. It doesn't need explaining. Goodbye to all of you."
I would just like to say it's been a privilege to meet you two today. You're so lovely. And thank you everybody else for coming. It's been an absolute privilege. Please have some more food and some drink and have a look at the puppets. And thank you so much for doing what you've done today as well. We're all very grateful in Marlborough that we're keeping this alive because it needs to be kept alive. Thank you very much.